Hello everybody, welcome back to the, hopefully, conclusion of our Doom 3 bullshit. We're gonna be doing Resurrection of Evil, finally, today. Which will hopefully close out our Doom 3 Chronicles for Halloween. There we go, just had to take care of something. So we make sure everything's all good. Okay, good. Anyways. So yeah, Resurrection of Evil takes place after the case of after Doom 3, and they're like, oh, fucking catastrophic mechanical failure. Oh, like one survivor. Okay, whatever, we're just gonna go and like set up again.
Dr. McNeil, they're close.
Yeah, you are random.
Red team, we're showing your position less than 100 meters from the signal. But there's no data suggesting any ancient civ development in that area.
I think they're up to something they just don't want us to know about. Some things never change around here.
There's some sort of chamber beyond this wall. Point, we need a charge here. Roger that, on my way. Dr. McNeil.
There we go.
Are you seeing this?
Yeah, spooky runes.
We're having trouble with your transmission. I need that stream brought back online now. Damn it. Can't see a thing.
Move slowly.
You're playing as a different Marine, dude. Well, you basically look the same, for the most part. But yes, you find a big glowing heart artifact thing. Touch it, it wipes everyone out. Uh-oh, demons. I see all these dudes and they're like, oh my god. Special Hell Knight variant, boys.
What's going on down there? We got a
Ah, yes. Back to this fucking shotgun. Yeah, this is literally the classic story of, uh-oh, we summoned demons again. Oh no, we fucked up, guys. Fucked up real bad. We accidentally went and summoned demons for like a third or fourth time, technically? And now we got, now only one man can fix our fuck-up. Oops. The world's single worst shotgun that you have to stick up an imp's nose. Which, thankfully, we don't have to use for long. Okay, I lied. You don't have to use it for long. Yeah, Resurrection of Evil very much did the classic expansion pack thing of, hey, here's more like Doom 3, but in more of a bite-sized package. Don't really want to chance that jump in case I fuck up. Some new additions here and there. Yeah, I don't think I can get over that. Oh, anyways. Your main difference is that you're playing as an engineer boy, and that basically means you get access to this game's version of the gravity gun. This thing only reinforced my comment earlier of this game wants to be Half-Life so fucking bad. Like, my god. It even added the fucking gravity gun. Like, I forgot that I can basically one-hit kill fucking Lost Souls. Yeah, this thing's genuinely, like, a useful weapon. Like, honestly, underrated Doom 3 gun. Also, said Ravney team saddle up, very dig, one message. Basically all that shit going on.
The UAC AM3 series portable power
pack
is an ideal redundant energy solution for military.
Stop. Okay. No, we don't give a shit, we don't need to hear about it. Anyways. Come on, where'd you go? There you are. Yeah, lost souls are still fairly annoying. Because they kind of fly erratically and you kind of just have to hope that you're pointed the right direction. Anyway, let's go up this big, weird fucking stairway. Yeah, basically I'd describe this as the gravity gun, but less fucking useful. Because I can't fucking catch anything because the radius is too small. Thank you, Doom 3, real cool. But hey, it insta-kills lost souls, so that's something, I guess. You can also grab stuff off of like ledges, which is nice. It's basically if Half-Life did it, you could probably use it in the same way. Anyways. Main dig site. We're not getting off to a great start, because we're already reusing some stuff. Oh boy. The shotgun. I hear it, I don't see it though. Yeah, atmosphere wise, it's still on point. However, I'm docking a few points because it kind of reuses some very similar looking areas. Like this area basically is like a rehash of what's it called? All right, spooky jumpy boys. I think that was supposed to just be a stronger version of the imp. Oh, wait. this is the first boss fight.
Welcome to your death.
That's the first boss, everybody.
Was this human? This fight has only just begun.
Marine? Come in, Marine. Same strength as back to broadcast level.
Listen carefully. This isn't the first time we're facing this, but I need more information. The artifact you recovered is obviously capable of incredible power. May also be the source of this invasion. Do whatever it takes to get the artifact to me. I'll try to contact the others.
But yeah, this thing fires a bit weird. This is why I don't remember using it, like, a ton. Once I got certain other weapons. So yeah, with this artifact you eventually get other powers and shit, and one of the big first ones you get is like the time stop power. But you don't really need to use it in some situations because of, well, reasons. Yeah, eventually this artifact is pretty ridiculous from what I remember. basically it was, I think if I remember right, by the end of the game it becomes a berserk, an invulnerability, and a bullet time all in one. Which, you know, is on its own kind of rad as fuck, but at the same time kind of breaks the fucking balance of everything. I also think you fire slightly faster with it too, so that's a thing. Do you think there's a way to get to that? I think this is the way forward, so I'm gonna go backtrack. There we go. And no audio logs. Undeliverable security codes. Security codes stored in the log between me. All hell's broken loose here. Message did not reach. That's all of a sudden it's gotta be reached. 550 security. I guess I'll try 550. Oh. Oh.
Audio log for Marcus Tanner, team coordinator. We shouldn't be here.
516.
I think we. This dig site. We've seen
structures
like this before, represented in tablets sent back to Dr. McNeil. Up until now. We hadn't seen any artifacts in what must have been their original state.
There we go.
There seems to be some sort of defense mechanism in place, attacking those godforsaken creatures. Why did the gate open? The amount of chaos and movement within is new to all of us. Our team never did anything. He was planning something. What it was. The best bet is to see this place up and get the hell out of here. We didn't come here for this.
But yeah, I don't really find the new artifact they have as cool as the Soul Cube, because the Soul Cube kind of fit seamlessly into the combat. feels a bit out of place a lot of the time. This is also down to the fact where it feels like a lot of fucking sections use the use certain elements of the artifact thing as like a crutch to masquerade some of the not so well put together fights. Which isn't super apparent right now, but later on it gets kind of. Gets a little rough to look at. Storage facility, blah blah blah. Okay, cool.
Marine, come in. Come in, Marine. Good. Dr. Cloud just contacted me, and he may be able to help. He has the recently discovered tablet ready for translation. He's missing an important section known as the primitive. It's a type of cipher key. He found the primitive years ago, but didn't understand how to use it until now. We must get the primitive from artifact storage and take it to Dr. Cloud in the Arabs labs. A tablet may be the key to understanding some of this. Heal out.
Yeah, some of these sections look a little copy-pasted. Especially this one. Like, neat vibe, they kind of kept the same feeling as the first game, but, well, the base game, I mean to say, not the first game, but, hey, you want to fuck you. Yeah, some complaints might seem a little bit nitpicky, but I honestly hold true are the fact that there's still a lot of things that they kind of try and do in here that I feel Half-Life and Half-Life 2 did a lot better. Like, they were like, yeah, here's a gravity gun thing. I'm like, okay, cool, but, like, realistically, I prefer a Half-Life 2 gravity gun because there's a lot more versatility within the environment, and it's not as annoying to use. I mean, yeah, I can pick up and eat smaller enemies, which is cool, but, you know. You could do that to some extent with, like, against headcrabs and shit, not eat them, but you can still do damage to them. And, you know, you can hold stuff like this infinitely and not have it crap out. Be safe up there. Target practice. And hey. As to objection, security breach, shell personnel artifacts, storage object. Message sent via security net was investigated complete movement to call a proper report. So yeah, it tries to shove in a few sections like that where it's like, hey, you gotta use the artifact and like... Oh, okay, cool. Yay, slow-mo cutscene. Hey, gravity gun that's nowhere near as useful, cool. Yeah, it's a few cutscene, like a few like set PC bits where it's like, hey look, here's a thing that you gotta slow things down for, wow. And like it kinda works. Keyword kinda. Okay. I think that was just for some extra supplies. And it slows the ridiculous fall damage that will fucking miss your health if you get, like, a 2-foot drop. Oddly enough, it actually makes the shotgun a little more useful. So you can't actually store multiple charges, cool. I forgot the code for the security ship. It's the wrong combo, cool. Excuse me, sir. Yeah, I don't think physics bullshit really works against dudes, like, at all. Like, again, it's not like the Half-Life gravity gun where you can kind of get away with picking up, like, whatever. And, like, flinging it at them. Oh, I wonder what this...
Get away! Stay back! Get it!
Don't get too close.
I'm not okay.
No, keep away.
Oh, he's turning into a zombie. Cool. Get annoying. Can take it hanging there, Mr. Rupert. Blah 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 blah. Request for transfer updates, carry codes. 769. Storage. Offices. Yeah, offices. Yeah, a lot of these areas are very, like, similar to Doom 3 in their kind of execution and everything, like base game Doom 3. There's a few curveballs and they aren't like bad, but early on you're not gonna feel super like... It's not gonna feel like there's a lot of different shit going on, you know? Finally figure the codes at 428. Oh, okay. Then you get this fucking thing. And oh boy. Well, let's get going. We saw this in the Lost Mission earlier, but when this first got introduced, I was like, so good compared to the base game shotgun. Like, I don't care that it's eating double the ammo. it's still really fucking good. Still in that oddball phase of horror games where they thought it was really fucking spooky to put like some weird shit on your screen. Juke. Don't mind me. Now that is the thing, I'm not like a video game snob. I'm not gonna be like, oh, fucking, like, you know, oh, this is just here as a gimmick, blah, 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 blah. Like, it's fair enough that this is just a cool feature. Filtration system now active. Contaminants detected. Commencing storage containment filtration. Storage containment filtration. Like, being able to do that makes some otherwise kind of bland gunfights a lot more interesting. Especially if you combine, like, the super shotgun that they have. Which, again, honestly, isn't a bad super shotgun. It could be better, yes, but it ain't bad. Yep.
Hey! You! I'm up here! The power's been knocked out down there. The surge overloaded the generator.
Yeah, no shit.
You're going to need to find two power cells to get that lift working. From up here, we can make our way to the surface. Hurry!
So yeah, like I said, Resurrection of Evil has a few gimmicks. One of which is the special artifact thing. That it lets you wreck face, basically, temporarily. As well as solve certain puzzles. Ow. Fucker. The other is this gravity gun that only works about half the time. Deciding that the height of horror is being able to fucking throw an imp at you that you can't avoid. And, like, you know, for the most part, it's mostly ups. Like, it's not bad. And they made some improvements between, like, 3 and Resurrection of Evil. Let's see if I've got any PKs.
Audio log for Dr. Victor Cargo, science officer. I feel fairly confident that once we get the missing tablet, we'll confirm our belief that there is somehow a connection
between
the translating as hunters and the beacon that our excavation teams are searching for.
Actually, wait a second. Oh, hello. Let's see, the other security log. 937, okay. Wow, that's weird. Did I forget to grab something and offend the door? I probably forgot to grab something. That opens into that. Pretty sure. Everything. So I gotta go somewhere else. No. Is the door just being broken? Am I blind? I probably am. Yeah, Resurrection of Evil, for the most part, is just kind of fine as an expansion pack. And it kind of worked on some of the strengths of the original and made some of the annoyances less annoying. And added some cool toys to play with. Which I guess is the best thing you can kind of ask for in an expansion. Wait, did I come through this hallway already? Yeah, I did. Okay. A little bit confused. Let's see if it tells me. Okay, it didn't say shit. Unless it was in the previous one. And 97. Oh, it works for the whole floor. Okay, cool. Yeah, main problem with the little energy grabby thing from Resurrection of Evil is that it doesn't really feel useful, it just feels really fucking gimmicky, and that's kind of a problem. It's a big problem when the game expects you to use it in some sections and it just doesn't really function. Like, that's an actual, honest to God, like, big problem. Insert. Thank you. See, I'm not even saying that the Doom 3 shotgun needs to be as powerful as this thing. However, when the double barrel, which is implied as being a sawn-off, has less spread, you might have a problem. You might have an issue. Like, once again, I hate to keep banging on this point, but regular Doom 3 shotgun. What the fuck? Sawn off. Kind of what the fuck, but the pellets seem to do more. And it's a sawn off. Insert. That dude up there is totally dead. Like 100% he did not live. Yep, there we go. Cerberus control. Sewer level, fuck. That. Great PDA. And honestly, like, there's not really a whole lot to say about Resurrection of Evil besides, like, the power-up stuff is maybe a bit neat, but apart from that, like, eh. It's kind of just down to it's more Doom. It's more Doom 3, and they kind of do an okay job with it.
Frankly, I don't know if our systems can handle too many more of these power surges. We're working with old equipment here. If I don't get the primitive soon, it'll be too late.
See? Told you he'd make it.
Oh. Speak of the devil. Your marine has the primitive.
Let's get the computer started on the translation.
Uh-oh.
Damn! Another surge.
Still there? Dr. Cloud, are you there?
It's working. It's all here. Amazing. Everything is right here. The invasion, the demons, it's all exactly the same as the ancient writings.
Dr. McNeil, our assumptions were correct. The artifact is a weapon of unbelievable power.
That explains Betruger's obsession with the ancient civilization.
Yes, but it looks like there's more to all of this than we had thought. The ancients write of three unstoppable beasts, horrific and powerful demons they called the Hunters. Apparently a reference to their protection of the artifact. I'll contact you when I know more.
Good luck. I'll be in the Phobos labs.
This is starting to make some sense. Not only is the artifact a source of great power, it's also a gateway. One-way portal from hell to our dimension. I need to gather more information here, but Dr. McNeil is an expert on the ancient civilization. You must get the artifact to her if we're going to understand how to destroy it. Take the key to the armory. We need some extra firepower.
Oh, shit, thanks, dude. Oh. Anyways. Yeah, like, I don't find Doom 3 to be particularly hard in a lot of ways. And that's usually when that comet bites me in the ass and something murders me, but like... A lot of it comes down to just barrel stuffing things with the shotguns and then winning. Spamming enough rockets and plasma to make a cyber demon blush. What does this dude have to say? Report back. Preparation so that we need ammunition fast. Protect stockpiles and blah, 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 mail problems. Okay. Right. Doom 3 is my favorite Half-Life game. No, I'm kidding. It's still low. Okay, I can move the barrel, I guess, over here. Can I drop the thing, or is it gonna... No? Okay, cool. There we go. There's the armor. Oh, chain gun. Cool. Okay, nothing. This one's kind of neat. Now, fucking. Stupid babies, fuck you. Right, I can just use the gravity gun. I don't care, I'm not gonna stop calling the gravity gun. Fuck you. Oh. Yeah, I thought this was gonna... Shoot. You gonna do it? Come on, you can do it. Okay, fuck you, dummy. Okay, this is the same hallway. This is the same hallway, sir. You are padding for content. Sir, this is the same fucking hallway you have copied and pasted 3 fucking times. I am quite frankly sick of it. The same fucking enemy at the end of it. Just because you change the length of the hallway or change where the fucking pipes are doesn't mean that it isn't the same fucking hallway. Like, bruh, come on. Okay, it'd be nice if I could fucking grab the things properly. Okay, cool. Ragehound, thank you for the raid. Hello. 14, holy shit, hi. So hello everybody, we're playing through the rest of Doom 3 stuff, we're playing the expansion Resurrection of Evil, which is trying really hard to be Half-Life, so yes, hello everybody. Finished making Cursed Halloween Glamours, nice. Oh my god, this is the same fucking hallway. Okay, I have a rant. So, like, literally, I'm playing through this expansion, and they're like, oh yeah, sewer level. I'm like, cool, that's fine, it's gonna be a short sewer level, whatever. And it is copied and pasted the same fucking hallway 4 goddamn times. And just to illustrate this point, I'm going to walk back to the first fucking hallway. Seriously, this is literally the same fucking hallway, basically. I don't care if there's small variations between it, this is the same thing, you've just changed up the length of it a bit. God damn it. One has weird stuff just for you. Ooh, nice. But yeah, I've been playing through this, the rest of this, because we beat Doom 3 last night. And I figured, okay, might as well go through the rest of the expansion tonight. I bet you 10-1 there's gonna be a big boy at the end of one of these hallways. I'll be real, I forgot what hallway we're in because, like, they copied and pasted so many fucking times. Maybe do the teleports up here? No, it's gonna be up here instead. You're gonna be a big dude? No? Okay. Always all look the same. Okay, this is definitely a bit that they copy-pasted. Yeah, we're playing through the rest of this for Spooky Month because it's probably the spookiest Doom 3 mod. Or sorry, spookiest Doom game. But at least the attempt at the spookiest Doom game. Running through this a little bit.
Hey! You! Over here! These things have kept me alive. There are more bots around, but I've sent them into the tunnels. Remember, they're on your side. Stay close to these bots if you want to live.
So we're in the expansion packs, they added a bit of crazy shit, like the ability to just do bullet time with a certain limited number of power-ups. They added the super shotgun back in. It's actually not bad compared to this awful metal slug thing. But yeah. My rant aside, how How did Final Fantasy go, apart from making glamours and stuff? Because I popped in a little bit, but my brain has been kind of fried because I got like 2 hours of sleep last night. So it's one of those cases of I'm kind of here today, but I'm also kind of not, just because, like, you know. Okay. Oh, not bad, just bumped off a few glasses for tomorrow. Oh, nice. That's an appointment. 1, 3, 4, okay. Yeah, it's good to hear that that's on track for tomorrow. So that's unfortunate. A sentry revival. Also honoring the donation stuff, we're still doing this without the flashlight or saving. So that's a thing. Go down the ramp because it's too tall. That's actually kind of stupid. But yeah, I'll definitely try and pop in at some point during the big long out stream. My own sentry bot just lit me up there. That sucks. Thanks for the follow-up. Red Lucky 4449. Oop. Ow. I got face-hugged by Revenant. Okay. Okay. Oh, health station. Turn around. There we go. That was easy. Boss fight number two down. Yeah, technically, if we're going by bosses alone, we're about halfway through the game. Because there's one more weird boy that you get powers from, and then there's the final boss. Do-do-do-do-do-do. Now the artifact on top of slowing time also gives me berserk powers, which means I can basically one-hit punch any sort of death I feel like. Which is a little dumb. Yeah, Doom 3 definitely came out at that very, like, odd time of gaming, where it's like, it felt like a lot of games didn't know what they wanted to be. So they kind of feel like weird amalgamations of every other game combined. Fuck you. to move. Wee. I probably shouldn't have just rushed through like that, but whatever, it worked. My thing is I need to find health. Oh, there's some health. I probably missed some health back here, actually. Oh, fuck. Whoa, hello. Fuck the health, I missed a whole fight back here. Hello. Whoa, whoa. Whoa, slow down there. Okay, I'm gonna pop this circuit to get out of this. Ooh. I'll take a win. You know, I move fast enough with Berserk. I might as well, like, get all of these. And get some extra health, because fuck it, why not? Honestly, due to how the little power-up goes that gives you the super speed powers, I can imagine speed runs for this are a little insane looking. Because if you pop Berserk, well, if you pop the Berserk level power-up, you go fucking fast, because you're not only slowing time, you're moving like twice at the speed, I think. And you're basically ignoring having stamina, I think, as well. Anywho, gotta find a PDA. Got a got twice on. Oh, that's a dude under the stairs. There you go. Zoom. I am speed. Uh-oh. Not good. I'm still good. I'm still fine. Insufficient power. God damn it. Really? Also invincible during this. Nothing there. Yeah, I really find Resurrection of Evil funny just because of how much it kind of spits in the face of its own kind of, like, thing it had ideas of, where it's like, we're gonna make a survival horror doom game, and it's like, okay. Then Resurrection of Evil happens, and it's like, okay, well, you get a power-up that basically just gives you invincibility and berserk in one, as well as a time stop. It's like, okay, cool. It's fun, but it kind of... It's a little funny after how, like, Doom leaned really hard into the whole survival horror feel. And also the fact that it still attempts to try and be spooky after, like, you know, giving you the ability to just pop a berserk whenever you feel like and go ham on people. Probably a PDA for this. I'll try 1 through 4 again. No. I gotta find a different one. That goes nowhere.
Log for lab technician Bernard Fresco. 12:27. As requested by the security division, we have changed the code for storage cabinet 042 to 714. I'm not sure why it's so important to use these damn codes all the time personally. It's not like I've cleaned and stored all the equipment in preparation for the upcoming expedition. Hopefully the next team will catch up what happened on the previous trip. Admittedly, I'm extremely curious about the entire jump process.
That's curse looking. Can't catch me, I'm the gingerbread man. For a little bit. Ooh, I don't like having a good sprint. Ow, 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 ow. Luckily, Revenant rockets kind of feel like light tickles and not anything actually serious, so that's cool. Yeah, I've gotten into this argument with people before about Doom 3, and they were like, oh, well, you can play it fast, and blah, 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 and I'm like, yeah, that's not the point. You can play it a bit faster, but the pace and the everything is still off. Like, you can get away with it, but it's not exactly advised. Uh-oh. Oh, dude, you're screwed. Oh, I'm screwed. He's gonna toss that shit right at me, isn't he? Yep. Oh. Never mind. Well, that was a thing. Thank you. here. Anything useful? Maybe? No? Okay. Just there. And Phobos Labs. Not really digging on the flashing lights. Big boy fight? Oh, this room's copy-pasted too. I've seen this room before. God damn it, guys. Okay. Oh, time for punches. Okay. Oh, I blew through this area too quickly.
God, it's good to see you. There's so much I need to explain, but we don't have much time. The artifact is a gateway from hell. Much like the one that the Truger opened with the teleporters in the Delta Labs. With the artifact, though, as long as it resides in our dimension, there's always the danger of it being awakened, and then another invasion. The ancients knew it, and now we know it. It must be returned to the source of its evil in order to be destroyed. They couldn't do it, so they locked it away and fought to their death. You can use the Delta Teleporter to return the artifact to hell for good. I know this sounds crazy, but it's the only way. The important thing right now is getting the Phobos Teleporter online. There are four core systems that must be shut down before I can reroute the power to the Teleporter. Take this. You'll need it to get to the pumping station. Now go.
So yeah, Doom 3's story is a little bit weird, because they're like, oh, there was this ancient, you know, powerful thing that could summon demons and shit, and blah 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 blah. And it's like, okay, cool, but. Like. Why would they make a thing that just summons fucking demons? I don't know. Okay, I go this way, I think, first. I'm gonna assume I gotta go this way first. Nah, fuck it. Fuck this section. Fuck you. I hate this outside bullshit where it's like, hee-hee. You gotta go through an airlock.
Pump disengaged. Pump station shut down.
Fast for you, fuck you. Ow. Fuck you. Ow. Another one teleporting in. Okay. Oh, hello. I'd like to also point out, I'm playing this on Veteran.
Super Turbo Turkey Puncher.
Oh, this is a thing too. Okay, not bad. We gotta finish this out. Let's put it in place just to slow me down. Artifact schematics, bridge code 281. Okay. 281.
Attention, automated turret guns offline. Service bridge now operational.
Oh hey, get the plasma gun. Okay, we're good. I'm gonna assume this is gonna take me to the right place I need to be. I'll just get that out of the way. Oh. Okay. This looks big and ominous. That's a thing. Oh.
Good. Now take the Skytram to the reactor complex. You can access the last two systems from there.
I just like how eventually they're just like, ah, here's invulnerability, fuck it. Excuse me. Oh, the gallery's getting opened up. Cool. Okay. Yeah, I feel like Resurrection of Evil was a direct response to people going, well, the combat's too slow. And then being like, well, fine, we'll make it faster. Definitely a weird flex. Be Half-Life so bad.
Thank you.
these lost souls, because it's the only thing this game has left. You gonna send any more? Yeah, you're gonna send more. Hey. Evening. Hey, Armor, what's up? Nothing way to get tired. Oh, okay. Time to punch things. I just minced the shit out of everything. Buzzwick is playing in Horizon and not car racing mode. Oh, okay. It's fine. Fists that inaccurate. I can't see shit. fucking hurts. Airlock, oh boy. That was a slightly closed section. Cargo tunnels.
Once you shut down life support, you'll have a limited amount of time to bring the teleporter online and transfer to Delta. We're on the right path. And more certain than ever that the trigger is somehow behind this. It's reaching out from the grave in one last desperate grasp for power. We need to end this.
Punch. Zoom. This is
Wait.
They had to have added one of these charges for BFG editions. I can't imagine it was actually this easy when it originally came out. Like, no fucking way. Because goddamn, this is just pure fucking easy mode carnage. Like, I'm just running around Mike Tyson's punch out and fucking everything. Had to have made this easier. There's no way it was actually this easy back in the day. Oh, right, I gotta just like teleport this dude. Come on. Select it.
Pad 1, selected.
I was gonna bring a big boy in. Okay, cool. Don't care.
System shut down.
Something spawned and it blocked me. Cool.
Pad
don't know why my screen's so dark. I guess story blocker 634. 634 to pick up the last whatever. 34. I'm kind of bull rushing my way through this. Weakness, a lift. Time to go into the teleporter. I forgot I had all these rockets. Mainly because I've been berserking everything to death. What's that, an excuse to berserk, you say? Don't mind if I do. Hello, goodbye. A jet. Well, hello. Yeah, I can really get away with this because it's gonna give me enough go-go juice at the end boss to, like, get shit done. Yep, I knew it. elixir of blood. Yeah, pretty much.
What did you hope to accomplish by coming here, mortal? You have something that belongs to me.
Throw fireball at me. I think that's what I think I understand what I must do. This is gonna be annoying. Okay, fine, let's throw a BFG at you. Fuck you. Thinking too much on this one. Too much think, not enough DACA. Okay, let's do that without dying. Alright, come on, can I skip the cutscene? No, it's not gonna let me. Cool.
What did you hope to accomplish by coming here, mortal? You have something that belongs to me.
Huh. Oh, that was weird.
Marine? Marine, welcome home.
And that was Resurrection of Evil with a weird-ass ending. Yeah. I mean, that was a thing. Overall, it kind of completely juxtaposition. It completely runs counter to the kind of gameplay that Doom 3 was going after, because of being able to chain berserk after berserk after berserk, but fuck it, it was fun. But yeah, that's it for tonight, and that's probably it for October, and going into November, I'm going to be playing maybe a few things as catch-up. But for now, we're going to find someone to raid. Let me just open Twitch. See who's around and who's doing what. Okay, we're gonna raid someone doing BRG. Yep. Yep, there we go. So, raid message. Fish is another valuable member of Team Underdog. So give them the big rocker raid and ask them how their day is going. And yeah, I will see y'all later.